another video coming at you. Happy to say that work is starting to settle down a little bit. And looking to get a few miscellaneous projects done. Got the transmission redone in Junior's T-Bird. That thing's running awesome. A few bugs on the Silver Bird, the Turd. And I tell you, it's been blazing hot this week. It's 100 degrees today. So I do need to get both these cars out and run them through the gauntlet, see how they hold up with the ambient heat. I'm confident Turd is going to do just fine with the radiator. That radiator is way overkill. So my concern is going to be the transmission temps. Other than that, this week I wasn't too active because it was so hot. I spent a lot of time online helping out another Super Coupe owner with some electrical problems. I don't know. I can't tell you how or why, but the electrical stuff talks to me. I never went to school for it. I've got no real formal training. I guess I learned by sticking my tongue on 9-volt batteries back when I was a kid. So some of y'all should try that. Maybe it helps. But it was a lot of fun helping out the car, just going back and forth with the Facebook messages. And we were able to get it sorted out. So that was pretty cool. Talked to a lot of people. Make a lot of new friends. You know, and they say, oh man, I need you to build a car for me. Oh man, I need you to put a turbo on this car for me. Man, will you tune this for me? Oh man, I need my exhaust mount done. Will you do that for me? No, I'm not gonna do it for you. I don't care how much you're paying. I'm not gonna do it for you. I'll gladly show you how. That's what I love to do. I will show you how to do it. Anybody can do this stuff. I'm sorry, anybody can do this stuff. You know, it takes just a little bit of muscle, but a lot of patience, a lot of tenacity, a lot of motivation. That's what this story is about. Had a Thunderbird owner who was struggling with a no start issue on her car, and we got it figured out. I didn't even have to touch the car. She did all the work, all of it, 100%. A little patience, a little research, and some sweat and tears. And in the end, it was a 5-cent fix. Didn't need a shop, didn't need special tools, didn't need special test equipment, didn't need a $30,000 scanner. Just had to dig into it. So this is the story that anybody can accomplish. You can all do it. Just gotta have some patience. And we may or may not squeeze in a burnout, we'll see. So working up against the wall today, which that's always fun. All I'm doing is throwing a plate in between here to fill this void and create some positive airflow through the intercooler when the fan is on and to help prevent any hot air from recirculating out from underneath the hood down this way. Hopefully result in a cooler air charge on the street. Also going to do a plenum around the air filter or above the air filter. I'm not sure yet how I'm going to do it, but again, trying to keep the underhood temps down or the inlet temperatures down. Get that to quit drawing hot air from under the hood. And we got it in there. Not totally done yet. You know, I'm going to use the old grounding lugs right there. But I'm just basically going to butt it up flush to the bottom of the rad support. And I need to, as you can tell on the reflection here, I need to bend this little bottom portion of it so it overlaps the intercooler there. It fills that little gap. I think that'll work. That should make a big difference, I would tend to think. Help the air draw from the radiator fan right through the intercooler. Guys, I'm sorry. I don't know why I do this. I get all pumped up to do a project, and then I plan on shooting a bunch of video and some time lapses and all that, and I don't know. Before I know it, I have it done and whipped out. Redid my intake tube. I had this little, I think it's a 25 degree, 3.5 inch intake tube that was just kind of stuffed on there, and the air filter didn't align right. I'm going to build an air box around here to isolate this filter from sucking in all that hot air, But anyway, fabbed up my little piece, made a nice little bend going around the shock tower there. And I'm pretty proud of that one. I need one little extension piece. I gotta get a 4-inch extension to go in here to bring my air filter all the way down in that corner. And then we're gonna box it off. It's gonna look real sweet. So, now what am I gonna do? I have no idea. I'll think of something else. Well, that's okay. I just figured out what I gotta do next. So, you know me, thinking ahead. I was gonna cut this out, make a nice area for it to draw some cold air in through there. Nice free flowing deal. Only problem is my trans cooler is right there. Space is not an issue, but how am I going to pull cold air in an area that's blowing hot air? So I think I'm going to have to relocate this to the other side or reposition it in some way. Started playing around with templates and figuring out what I'm going to do for the air box in this area. So that's the latest. Okay, the common sense is finally starting to kick in. We have a transmission cooler right down here that's in front, theoretically in front of the air filter. As the vehicle is traveling forward, the air is flowing this way. So, what would you do? Stand by for another time lapse!
This song started as a rant against haters.
This song started as a rant against haters.